in the spiritual efforts which we make here. An important place is generally given to vritti. Vritti, our attitudes, our outlook. So much so that even other people have defined yoga as control of vrittis. Yoga chitta vritti nirodha. They say yoga is the control of attitudes, outlook. Some say moods. There are 16 moods. We change our moods. We don't have a constant mood. Sometimes very happy, very elated, jumping with joy. Sometimes sad and sorrowful. So the mood of an alu and our spiritual efforts very much depend upon our attitudes and outlook. So much so that Baba has said, jaisi vritti vaisi srishti. Your creativity, your creation depends upon your vritti. And this morning I was trying to just recapitulate to my mind how many vrittis there are and what are the negative vrittis, which are the positive vrittis. I was not able to finish it before I came, but some of the vrittis I noted, 16 vrittis. These vrittis we have to pay our full attention to if we want to become Sola Kala Sampuran, if we want to have purity to the extent of 16 degrees, full purity, full bloom, then we have to pay our utmost attention to regulate them. One, for example, Baba has very often been mentioning is Guna Grahak Vritti, and the opposite of it is Avguna Grahan Vritti. Those of you who don't know Hindi at least should know both these terms because they are very significant. Guna Grahak Vritti. So that you are looking at the positive side of a picture, always trying to see good, think positive. Your attention goes to the good qualities, to the merits of a person, not to his shortcomings, his failures, his negative traits. How does it matter? Because the fundamental law is, as you think, so shall you become. If you continue to think the bad points in any person, if you want to become Sarva Avguna Sampan, actually our aim is to become Sarva Guna Sampan. But if you want to become the reverse of it, it is easy method. The method is you just think of the bad qualities in everyone, you see. And then you will have all that. That is ulti mala pherna, you see. Reverse of the rosary. So if you want to become Sarva Guna Sampan, if you want to have all the divine qualities, you should see one or the other divine quality in someone. Even the ugliest has some beauty. I once asked an artist to make the ugliest face. He tried his best number of times. Because if he makes one ugly face, he thinks it is not the ugliest. He would try to change. It had some quality. So also, even the vilest sinner, the person who you think is a criminal, a hardcore criminal, if you just try to go deeper into his life, you will find that he has some soft corner. There are some bright points in that person. They have compassion also. They have consideration for others also. They are very friendly also. It is the society also is responsible for making them criminals. The society sometimes pushes a person to become a criminal. It creates such hard circumstances for the person. So if you just pay your attention to good qualities in everyone, that is called gun grahak vritti. If therefore we want to become sarvagun sampan, all virtuous, having no blocks, black spots, then we should have this vritti, gun grahak vritti. Naturally, in your day-to-day life, you will come across some bad qualities in everyone. So how you can have that gun grahak vritti? How can you have gun grahak vritti? Then you explore the qualities of that person. And if you think this person has this good quality, then you become happy. This is the art of becoming happy in life. Hence, if we form the habit of looking at the bad things in everyone, then we make our own life miserable. It becomes difficult to live because there is no scarcity of bad in this world. It has become rotten. Therefore, if we really want to become yogis, one of the parts of our effort should be to have gun grahak vritti. Another is jigyasa vritti, learning attitude. We should try to learn. We have not become perfect. We are students. Baba says student life is the best. So if we have learning or learner's attitude, then we gain more and more knowledge. You don't grow old. A person who thinks that he has learned everything, actually he is an old person. Otherwise, a person who thinks that it is still much to learn, he is young, at least of mind. So, even in this spiritual effort, if daily we pay our attention to what is there in the Murli, which we learn today, if we have committed anything which was wrong, which was against Baba's Srimad, and we want to correct it, learning makes us correct. If we become obstinate, we think we have become perfect. Oh yes, we know. We ourselves also know. Why you advise us? We also are students who have been coming to this class for so many years. We know. That is the biggest problem for the seniors. They cannot give any correction to those people who have this attitude. We know. But if they think there is still margin, some scope for changing, for amending ourselves, then it is easy for those who take our responsibility to make us perfect. So we should have jigyasa vritti, the attitude of learning, that we are lifelong students. Then there is anasakta vritti. Anasakta vritti, which is very important for a yogi. the attitude of detachment. Like a lotus will live in this world. An example is given up to the lotus, of the lotus. Shri Lakshmi, Shri Narayan, Saraswati, all of them, when you see their pictures, they are shown sitting or standing on a lotus. When I was a child, I was surprised. The lotus is not crushed under their weight. How is it that they stand on the lotus, you see? And this lotus is still intact. Because I didn't know that it is symbolical, you see. Riding on the lotus, like an elephant riding on a rat, you know. What will happen to the rat? So, it is symbolical for our yogi life, detached life. It's very important. If the world is in your mind all the time, you are thinking of Devadaris. You have attachment for the Devadaris, embodied persons, physical persons. Then you are idol worshippers. Some people say idol worshipping is wrong. Even those who broke the idols in the Mecca or who are against idol worship, when they invaded our country, they broke the sacred idols which were worshipped by the people of then, that time. But they have in their mind the idols of their wife, of their child, of their friends, always thinking of physical persons. So, the murti, the devadaris, the embodied persons, the physical outer of a soul is in their mind. So, they say, though all the idols were thrown out of the Mecca, but the mind of the man is Budkada. There are still idols in it, and man is worshipping them. What happened to Gorbachev? His wife died, and he is kissing the dead body. All are kissing the dead body of the wife, Rosa Gorbachev or whatever was her name. People weeping, shedding their tears, you see. They think that we can't be without it. All their life, they have been with them. So, though there are two persons, but one is living into the mind of the other. Can't forget, you see. So, this is not anasakti. There is detachment. And that is the cause of pain in this world. So, as yogis, we have not only to detach from our body, our own body, but also from the bodies of others. What does the detachment from the bodies of others mean? You don't be always conscious of them. Take the case of Hare Krishna, Hare Rama. I was staying at one of their ashrams in Australia, in Sydney, because I had gone there for service, and in those days we didn't have any center. So I used to stay at some place which was a religious place. They had made an arrangement for me to stay there. So they have divided the whole world for the sake of their administration into six parts. One of the stalwarts was there at that time. They asked him to confront me. And we had a dialogue. And one of the things I asked him, when you worship Krishna or Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, you see, or Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Hare means green also, if not Hare Hare, yellow, yellow, white, white, but it means that, you see. They ask somebody, do you take garlic and onion? He said, Hare Hare. It means both things. One is I don't take. Why you are naming these bad things? The other is I take fresh, you see. Hare Hare. So, it is way of saying. Do you take wine? He said, Rama Rama. That means I take Rami. You see. That kind of drink. So it is a way of telling people. So I said, you are worshipping Krishna. But who is God? God is the Supreme Soul. He is not corporeal. The corporeal is made up of matter. Even the subtle body is made up of subtle matter. Why you call it body? Because it is not the soul. It is the soul's casing. Therefore you call it body. The very word body means that it is not the real thing which we are talking about. Something in it. So actually you mean to worship God, but you are worshipping Krishna, for example. Standing cross-legged, having the flute, with a crown. That is how they mention. And they sing invocation, song of Krishna. You are remembering all material things, you see. What was the age of Krishna which you worship? A baby, a young man, or a grown-up person? It is the body which grows. So you are trying to forget your own body, but you are trying to remember the body of Krishna. You have only transferred, you see. Still you are body conscious. You say you are practicing soul consciousness. But the body of Krishna is not the soul, it is the body of the soul, you see. He said. He began to think. Then people called him that there is some urgent work. So the talk was finished at that moment. But what I wanted to say is, this is the difference between Bhakti Marg, always worshipping the embodied person, Devi, Shakti, or Radha, Krishna. Some people worship Radha. They say to worship Radha is better because Krishna is very serious. He has a hard mind. If you pray to him, he may accept or not. But it is easy to persuade Radha, you see. Ladies, women can be persuaded easily. They are more compassionate, more loving, because they are motherly. So if you just are able to please Radha, she will get your work done from Krishna, you see. So, they are politicians even in religion, you know. So when we met them, some of them, they would say, Radha, Radha. We told them, God is Shiva. They will say, Radhe, Radhe. We will say, we should practice meditation. He will say, Radhe, Radhe. Because they always wanted to remember Radhe. And in order to do that, in reply to whatever you say, you may say, that man is dead. He will say, Radhe, Radhe. If that baby is born, Radhe, Radhe. You see. So that is what they say. So then we asked him, why you say Radhe Radhe, why not Krishna Krishna? He said, it is easy to please Radhe and get your desire fulfilled from Krishna through Radhe. So that is the strategy. Okay. So what I was saying is Anasakta Vritti, detached. And then Upram Vritti. You see, Upram Vritti. Your mind is calm. Quiet. And it is not pushing and pulling. There aren't many desires in it. It is not disturbed. So you have Upram Vritti, you see. That is very essential. Then Utsaha Vritti. Always have enthusiasm. Have zest. Because if we don't have enthusiasm, we are as good as dead, like a log of wood. What makes us living, what gives us the feeling of life, is the enthusiasm. We want to do something, we are very much alert and active, and kicking and doing. That is the sign of life. There is movement. And if there is that movement, that means there is a moving spirit behind it. So our spirit should always be high, you see. Utsaha, umang. Not we see some, when we see some persons, they look to be very dejected. very disappointed. Depression is one of the signs of the present civilization. Not merely mental tension. A companion of mental tension is depression. Some are disturbed because of tension, others are disturbed because of depression. Oh, we can't do anything. No one loves us. We don't belong to anyone. Life is useless. It is better to die. So who cares for us? So it is depression, effect of depression. They don't have the epileptical fits, you see, but these kind of fits of depression, it's another kind of fit, you see. So we are to be free from this, and there for that purpose we have to have the utsaha vritti, then vairagya vritti. Baba says vairagya vritti, behad ka vairagya. You already know Baba has so much enlightened us on this vairagya vritti. You are fulfilled. You don't run after anything. You are feeling that you are satisfied. There is nothing which you are running after. So this kind of thing, when you realize the very nature of this world, it is fleeting. It is ephemeral. It does not stay. What appears to you is illusory. What appears to you to be attracted, if you just look at the base of it, you find it is rubbish, actually. As compared to what things were in golden age, all things today are rubbish. They are rotten. The bodies of golden age, so pure, because we had fruits and juices, natural, not with preservatives, no fertilizers. The chemical fertilizers were used. Not that things were preserved in the freezers or in the refrigerators and they were given to eat after so many. We just had it from the trees. Fresh. Everything fresh. Sata Pradhan. Full of juice. Full of nourishing material. And we had no worry, no fear. So naturally our bodies were of different kind. Our enzymes and our glands gave some different kind of the quality of the secretions. Our adrenal gland, our pituitary gland, our other glands, they were working in a different fashion. The whole system has been disturbed because man has highly interfered with the system. The natural system is the most wonderful system. But human intervention, because of human follies, because of lack of their knowledge, they disturb it more and more. The whole rhythm is lost. If they want to correct one thing, another thing goes wrong. Because they do not know. All the things together, they don't have the full knowledge. They are trying to have the knowledge, explore the knowledge. But they say the nature is the best healer. And we were close to nature at that time. So much oxygen in the atmosphere, there was so much of green, and that was clean, everything was clean, no pollution and so on. So you could just imagine what the bodies of those deities were, and what other bodies as compared to today. And when we say, this person is beautiful, what do you mean by beauty? You are seeing only the plastic outside. In the bag there may be rubbish, but if the plastic is very colored and beautiful, you think it's a very beautiful bag. Can I see what is there in the bag? And when you see the bag, then you see a bad smell and germs and rotten things and rubbish, you see. It is because we don't have that penetrating sight. What is inside? The difficulty is that our eyes are outside, our ears are outside, our mouth is outside, everything outside, and inner power we have lost because we are not introverted. We don't have that kind of intuition. We have become very unnatural. There are certain powers which we have lost. Take the case of some animals. They are tied to a peg by means of a strong rope. And before an earthquake comes at some place, they pull at the tug and they want to break free. because and they jump, they are disturbed. They feel the earthquake is coming. It is much before the earthquake comes. Our meteorological department are not able to make that prophecy, but the animals are able to make it. And the birds begin to fly very high, the kites and others. And they collect together. They want to go to the safer place, you see. Something is going to happen. They understand it. We have lost that faculty. They say only 50%, less than 50% of our mind is working. The rest is asleep. It is atrophied. We have not been using those abilities. However wise we may consider ourselves, our wisdom is only of one faculty at the most. And it is not holistic. We don't have all this. So we had that quality. So what do you mean by beauty? Is that beauty? That means you don't know what is beauty. You go to an artist or you read books on art. They define what is purity. Try to define what is beauty. You will be surprised. As compared to what golden age was, it is not beauty. It is the opposite of it. The negative of it. So also the things which we eat. They say like the sugar cane, you have the juice and the rest is left, or what is left is the outer skin of the sugar cane, the roughage, and if somebody eats it, his gums will be injured. So it is that kind of thing which we are having. Like we throw certain things in our dustbins, and in India you know the dogs and the poor people fight among themselves. There is a marriage. After the marriage, they throw out the leftovers and the poor people, because they don't have that kind of dish which you serve in your marriage party, they are feeling tempted. The dogs also want to come because they say they also have their share. It was a marriage party where they were not invited. So they are invited, you see. So they are fighting among themselves for whatever is left over. So is that the kind of food which we are taking, you see, as compared to what it was in the golden age? So also everything in this world. So if we just have this kind of a feeling, that even this one, which we are all able to see, will be ultimately destroyed, the destruction is near, then do we love a person who is in the grave and the body is half eaten by the germs, you see, in a state of putrefaction, degeneration, giving bad smell? They say, jab teri arthi uthali jayegi, bin mahurat hi nikali jayegi. Whenever in India they hold any ceremony, any function, they go to the Pandit and say, Panditji, mahurat batao. You tell us the auspicious hora, the auspicious moment, when this marriage should be solemnized, or when this betrothal should be solemnized, or when this thing, that thing, or the other thing should be celebrated. But do they go to a Pandit to say, to ask him, when this dead body should be removed to the crematorium? No. Bin mahurat hi uthani jayegi, jab pari arthi nikali jayegi, you see. Then they don't think of this. And we know what is going to happen. We are all already on the deathbed. Or at least we have our legs in the grave. Up to this, you see. Only the little portion is left. Because the destruction is very near. So still we have attachment for this world, a rotten thing. So we should have a rag vritti. The rest we will talk some other time. Thank you, Om Shanti.